You have to do something to secure the border. We don't have a country without a border. Without a border, we just don't have a country.
That, of course, GOP frontrunner Donald Trump discussing the importance of border security on Morning Joe back in July. Now, this is an issue that remains a hot button issue in the 2016 campaign. But now the president of the National Border Patrol Council, Brandon Judd, testified yesterday before Congress and told us that just 40% of the United States-Mexico border is under operational control, and that's on a good day. During his testimony, Mr. Judd also said that one in every five illegal immigrants caught at the border are criminals, adding that while some believe that lower apprehension rates indicated a more secure border, this is simply not the case, according to Mr. Judd. This is the challenge we are facing at the border today. There are those who will point to lower apprehension rates and tell you the border is secure. Border Patrol agents, however, throughout this nation will tell you that the border is not secure, and the Southwest border certainly is not safe. So Border Patrol is saying that the border is not up to snuff. Question is, how do we make it better? Amy, more patrol officers, a bigger, stronger Trump wall with a beautiful door in the middle? I mean, what do we do?
Well, I think we certainly do need to give more support to our Border Patrol, increase the numbers, and actually President Obama agrees with that and claims that he's done just that. But we also need to address the magnet. What is drawing all of these illegal immigrants to cross the border illegally? And that has to do with policy, and it has to do with President Obama basically granting amnesty and waving a big green go sign for all of these folks. And by the way, it is not humanitarian. When you see the stories about all the people losing their lives from human smugglers trying to go across the desert and bodies, burial grounds being found, I mean, it's really a tragedy for many of these people.
Joe, here's what I often wonder about. I wonder if we're still having a debate about something that's seen a significant change already. We know now that 40% of the illegals in this country are people who came in on visas. When the visas expired, they just stayed because the government doesn't seem to know how to find them.
Like Jorge Ramos.
Yeah. So we know that that's the case. We also are told, if we can believe the statistics, that we have a net zero in terms of Mexicans coming in. And I'm only speaking about Mexicans. There are certainly other people south of the border that come. A net zero, Mexicans coming in and Mexicans going out. Are we over-focused on this southern wall, where maybe we should be putting some more of our focus on other things?
Other things like the northern?
I'm not even going to go to the northern thing that mm-hmm. Scott Walker suggested, but maybe more on how to track people that have come in legally.
Like the Chris Christie idea with FedEx and,
yes.
and tracking
people.
Yeah, which was made to be inhumane, but I got what he was trying to say.
E-verify.
Look, there are plenty of things that we could do here. National Guard, for instance. Well, we have hundreds of thousands in reserve. You could make them Border Patrol agents, in essence, obviously, in shifts.
As the law currently stands, you couldn't, because of posse comitatus. You could change that law and make that possible.
Right. I don't think anybody would have a problem with that. We have drones that we're using in terror. We could use that all the time as well.
Do.
And then you find out where the most common crossings are, because building a 1,900-mile wall, that's going to take a very long time and a lot of money, and maybe not. It can't be done. The most common crossings, and then strengthen those areas in terms of walls and borders and so on. And then you're going to cut it down by half at least, and that's an improvement.
You have to come down and look at the cartel, too. The cartel own territory into America.
So,
and one of the big issues, too, which draws people to America is our economy. People are coming here looking for jobs. They're getting jobs, and they're getting cash jobs. If you go to a Western Union on a Friday afternoon after payroll, there is a line out the door of people who are generally not of American descent, or what would appear to be American descent. So the issue is here. We are putting money, and they are exporting it back to their home countries. If we could stop that flow of money somehow, if we could tax the money leaving America from Western Unions, from things like that, we could actually make a big impact on this, as well as, you're talking about the National Guard, and you can't do that, but here's what you could do, volunteer militia. You put people on the border as a volunteer. I would volunteer to go down there for a week and man a post. And you would get thousands of people.
I appreciate the courage to do that. I'm not sure deputizing citizens to be in confrontations, as you mentioned, even with drug cartels, is a good idea. But when you see a sign, as what was put up in Arizona, that it was a warning on Arizona land,
right,
a warning to American citizens, do not step foot here because it's too dangerous,
right,
and it's been given over to a Mexican drug cartel. I mean, that's outrageous. The federal government should be defending American citizens and American
land. It's like a drug caliphate.
20 million veterans out there, I guarantee you 15 million of us would volunteer to go sit by that border.
But even setting aside the volunteer, which may be a way to go, I'm not sure I agreed with all of your approaches, but at least you have some, and that bears notice and respect. Yeah. The question I would ask is, even if we beefed up the border patrols, whether by employing them or elsewise, can you really cover the whole southwestern border?
It'd be very difficult, but here's what you do. You also incentivize people to come through legally. Make the citizenship standards easier to obtain.
Okay, that's the last word on that. Yeah. Are you surprised to hear that only 40% of the southern border is under operational control? If you are, go to NewsmaxTV.com/comments. Let us know what you have to say about it. And coming up next, we're going to read some of your viewer comments, so don't go anywhere.